I'm joined now by Bill Murray. He's the organiser of the Brighton Big Screen. Bill, thanks for joining me. First of all, yeah, we've got to mention the beds we're sitting on. It's not your traditional sort of movie watching seat, is it?
No, this is it. We thought we'd be a bit different at Brighton's Big Screen. So we've built a whole series of bedrooms thanks to Ibis's new suite bed. And you can sit in a suite bed in front of the screen in abject luxury. We have a wonderful decked garden. There's really, really luxurious beds, and actually you can sit, you can have drinks and food and watch the movie as you please, or watch the football or Wimbledon finals.
So you get
from
all
bed.
The food brought to you?
Absolutely.
That's
you
brilliant.
Can order it. So it literally is abject luxury in bed.
Fantastic. Well, sporting wise, we've got to talk about the Euros. The game is being shown on the big screen. How exciting is that, that people can come down and enjoy the football together on such a big stage?
Yeah, do you know what, Jamie? I think that's absolutely right. I think it's a real connectivity, because football, any major sport, in fact, we know with movies as well, but football has a real way of kind of connecting people, and it's that lovely kind of bond that you get. And when you've got, we can get up to 5,000 people here, you've got 5,000 people watching a 40 square meter screen in the surroundings. You've got the Palace Pier, you've got, you know, literally the whole kind of set out, restaurants, bars. There's something very special about being outdoors watching an amazing tournament.
Obviously, like you mentioned, you've got Wales, got England, got Northern Ireland, got Republic of Ireland. But it's not just sort of the UK and Ireland that's involved. And with Brighton being the city, is such a multicultural city, I guess it's going to be great to see so many people from all different countries coming down and supporting their countries down here.
You're right. You're absolutely right. It's when we did the World Cup, England crashed out, obviously, and I thought that was it. You know, I was all set to kind of pack up and go home. I realised then we have such a strong German, French, Spanish, really great cross-section community. Eastern Bloc countries as well were fantastic fans. So we had an amazing World Cup 2 years ago with England fans coming down to support the other games. And it was a glorious kind of celebration of football. So we got to that point where everyone was enjoying the football again. Mm. And even, I dare I say, if England do go out, it kind of takes the pressure off a bit to enjoy the tournament a bit more than just kind of, you know, willing it to kind of go our way. So I enjoy the whole spectacle of football. I like the smaller games as well, because I think the atmosphere is great, and it's lovely to see how Brighton is so diverse.
And obviously football is all about the atmosphere, and I guess you're hoping that, we're all hoping that, you know, down here in front of the big screen on the seafront, it's going to create a great buzz for the city.
This is it. I mean, we've concentrated on, you know, providing the best arena we could possibly do. We have really pulled out all the stops to, you know, with our partners Ibis, with Bondi Beer, with, you know, some of the other things we work with, the University of Brighton, you know, even down to Healy's, our solicitors. We've come together, you know, we're working with an awful lot of the major businesses in the city. Because this is a celebration of what we do best. We are on the beach, we are having a beverage, in moderation obviously, enjoying some fantastic food, and getting the vibe of what football's all about and what big movies are all about.
Finally then, we've mentioned it in sort of little chunks throughout this talk, but people can just as easily sort of go down to their local pub and have a beer and watch the games. Well, what would you say to really encourage people to come down to the big screen, watch it on the seafront?
I think it's the family element. I think it's the kind of fact that we have, you know, a very secure area. We have 30 or 40 guards that, you know, keep it very, very safe. For the last 5 years, we've never had an arrest. It's been a very, very jovial atmosphere the whole time. It's safe, like I say, it's fenced, it's secure, it has everything you need. First aid, lost children, provisions for toilets, everything. So it's just a simple one. You walk down, you enjoy free football, and hopefully have a beverage or something to eat from our lovely restaurants.